Hello, everyone. My name is Eileen O'Neill Burke. I'm the current president of the IJA, and I'm here today with Illinois Supreme Court Justice David Overstreet, who is also the first VP of the IJA, to talk about all things IJA. How are you, David? How was your holiday?
Doing great. Had a wonderful time with the family. Got to spend time with them. Also, saw a tribute band to a Trans-Siberian Orchestra. That was a lot of fun. Went to a retirement party for Judge Richard Brown from Randolph County, who served on the bench for 18 years. And I binge-watched The West Wing.
Oh, you did? I've never seen that. And everybody keeps telling me I got to watch it. So I'm going to put that on my list.
I never had watched it either. That's just one episode led to another.
Great. Okay, what are our backdrops today?
Well, today I've got Bedford Falls, which is a scene from my favorite Christmas movie, It's a Wonderful Life.
And that didn't surprise me at all when I said, send me your favorite Christmas movie. Mine is The Christmas Carol, but the original Alistair Sims version. So today we've got some great news. Every single judge in the state of Illinois was retained. The retention committee worked really hard on creating a handbook for retention elections. It's posted on the webpage on the IJA website. If you're just coming off your election cycle, please take a look at it and let Allison Conlon and Bobby Petragonero know if there's anything that needs to be added or changed. What else happened this month, David?
The pro bono day of service was a huge success. In the beginning of November, judges all over the state worked in food pantries. My friend Rita Garman joined in Champaign. The 10th Circuit collected thousands of dollars just from judges to donate to local food pantries. This was such a big success, it's going to be an annual event. So please mark your calendar for the first Saturday in November, November the 4th. Let's talk about the mid-year meeting at the JW Marriott on December the 9th. Who are giving the awards this year at the luncheon?
I'm so excited about this. So we're honoring some really spectacular people. If you're going to the luncheon, stop listening right now because I'm going to repeat all this at the luncheon and it's going to ruin it for you. So the first award we're given is the Emeritus Award, and it's given to those who have shown exemplary leadership while on the bench and those who have chosen to continue serving the judiciary as Emeritus Counsel. So we created Emeritus Counsel last year, and it is comprised of all retired appellate, retired chiefs, and retired presiding judges. They are there for consultation with any judge who's getting criticized in the press or having difficulty with something. The Justices Ann Burke and Rita Garman will be co-chairing Emeritus Counsel with Justices Carmeier, Kilbride, and Thomas. Justice Robert Gordon is also joining Emeritus Counsel. And so I'm super excited to have all three of them receiving this award this year. Who else are we honoring, David?
The Civitatis Award. Civitatis is Latin meaning of or from the community. And the award winner is Justice Cynthia Cobbs, who is the first district chair pro bono. And it is given in recognition of a lifelong commitment to community service and for leading judges in their work serving on the public on and off the bench.
That's great. She's very, very deserving of that award. She has spent decades in public service, so I'm glad to be honoring her in that way. I'm super excited about the next award too. It's called the Libertatum Award, and it is given in recognition of exemplary service to the judiciary. It's given to those who show a zealous commitment to the preservation of judicial independence and an unfailing devotion to judges and their welfare. There is one name that comes to mind, and it's Judge Anna Dimakopoulos, who has literally worked on the Judicial Independence Project for years, and it all came to fruition this year, which leads us to our next awardees, David.
The Amicus Award is given to someone not a member of the judiciary who is committed to maintaining an independent judiciary. It recognizes the advocacy and leadership on issues of significant importance to the judiciary, demonstrating that they are truly a friend of the court. Both Rory Weiler and Tim Tomasik were instrumental in getting our message out that judges must be independent from the political winds and evaluated on how they do their jobs and not what the political winds are blowing.
They were great. They did press conferences. They did editorials. They really did help us get our message out on that. So that's a wonderful award for them that I'm glad to be giving out. Jeannie Heaton, who's the director of the ISBA, is getting the Founders Award. It's also an award that goes to non-judicial recipients. You know, I learned really quickly when I first started this job as president that you do not mess with the retired judges. And the retired judges told me right at the get-go that we were giving Jeannie Heaton an award this year for all of the help that she gives the retired judges on coordinating their CLE and a million other things. And finally, the award that I'm most excited about is the Lifetime Achievement Award. It is bestowed on IJA members who have demonstrated extraordinary service to the IJA. It is given in recognition of many years of devotion to promoting a strong and independent judiciary. So it's going to this guy who has taught every new judge in the state civil procedure for the last 12 years. Someone who has taught, supervised, created content for EdCon for over a decade. He was the former Alliance of Illinois Judges president. He was the former Illinois Judges Association president, my dear friend, Jim Snyder.
Couldn't be a better choice than Jim. Yeah. And I apologize to my friend, Tim Tomasic, for butchering earlier.
So I don't think non-judges watch this thing anyway, so.
I look forward to seeing Tim at the luncheon because it's going to be a great luncheon. And Alexi Janulis, our Secretary of State-elect, is the speaker. There's a CLE in the morning that Jenny Johnson and Jim Snyder are in charge of called The Future of Delivering Justice. Then immediately after the luncheon, we'll have our board meeting.
Also at the board meeting, I did a PowerPoint that has music in it. So anybody who's on the board, I'm kind of thinking it's going to be a little bit fun. So also next week, December 5th, is New Judge School. We have a reception for the 130 new judges on Monday, December 5th. So if you're a new judge, I hope you're planning to come to that. Also during New Judge School, we're having the in-schools programming training on December 7th at 4 p.m., right in the same place that the new judges are having classes. If you have never gone to a training and you'd like to come to a training, you are more than welcome. Let Kathy know that you're coming. Friday night is the Supreme Court reception. So that's a super busy week. One final thing, if you want to submit something to the gavel, the date is January 1st, and all committee chairs are going to be hearing me nag you about that soon. So, David, give us a fun fact about December.
Okay. Hey, I'm really looking forward to seeing everyone at the festivities next week. But as we look at December, I learned a couple of things here over the weekend. People all over the world have celebrations in December, of course. And in Austria, Santa's evil twin, Krampus, a half-goat, half-man demon, chases naughty children through the streets. And the Burning Clocks Festival in Brighton, England, is where paper lanterns are burned in an enormous bonfire on December 21st to mark the shortest day of the year. Now, that reminds me, one of my favorite days of the year is December 22nd, because the days start getting longer again.
Yeah, that's true. All right, happy holidays, everyone. And David, Merry Christmas. And I can't wait to see everybody next week. It's going to be a wonderful, wonderful week.